Hello guys, welcome to my channel HUI Tutorials. In this video, we will discuss about how we can handle window handles in Selenium WebDriver. So basically, what is meant by a window handle? But suppose you are in one website and you click on one button or a link which opens a new tab or new browser window. So this tab or browser windows, we call them as window handles. So now we'll see how these window handles look like and why we need to handle them and how we need to handle them. Okay. So let me open the website. So here I'm using this website, guys, huitutorials.com. So I'm also working on this Selenium practice. Then I'll click on window handles. So this page I'm going to use for practice today. So here I have designed 5 buttons. Each one is having a different functionality. Okay. If you see this one, the first button, when you click on this, it will open one new window. You see? So it will open one new window like this. So the second one, if you click on this, it will open new tab. So in the same browser, it will open new tab. And the third one is open multiple windows. Earlier in here, we opened only one window, right? So here it will open two windows. Okay. The same way, the last one is this one, fourth one is open multiple tabs. It will open two tabs in the same browser window. Then the last one is combination of this one and this one. When you click on this one, it will open two tabs as well as two windows also. Okay. So now we'll see how we can handle the windows and tabs. Before that, why we need to handle this window handles basically. Now I am in main window. So somehow I click on this open new window. And here I need to do the registration. I need to perform this registration. Then after the registration is successful, I need to close this window and come back to the original window. So how you can achieve this in Selenium WebDriver? So basically, when you are dealing with Selenium WebDriver, you will have driver instance, right? So the driver instance will hold this one web page only, right? So if you say driver.findElement, it will search in this old web page. So the driver instance will hold this single tab, the single instance. So here it is opening another browser window. So in that case, what WebDriver will do? Whether it will consider this original window controls as well as this extra window controls, or it will consider only this one and it will remove this one, how it will be behaving? So basically, when you open any new window or new tab, the Selenium WebDriver doesn't automatically handle that. Okay. The control, the focus will be always in the first opened browser window only. So this one. So this is my first open browser window, right? So the control will be in this one only. If I want to perform any operation in this browser, in this window, extra window, first I need to go to this window, then only I can find the controls inside this browser. Then I can perform the operations. After that, I can close this window and come back to original window, right? So here, if you want to find out any window or any web element, earlier we have seen, right? If you want to perform any action on any web element, what we will do? We will first find out that element using some locators. We have multiple locators like ID, name, class name, XPath, CSS selector, right? So we use some locators and we'll first find out the element. Then we will be able to apply the actions in that element, right? So the same goes here. But here, you don't have those many locators. So here we need to identify the window first. Then we can perform the operations inside that window on these elements. Okay. So here for finding this browser window, we have only one way, that is window handle. Okay. So we need to pass a handle. A handle is nothing but here every browser. So this browser, if you see, normally what will happen when you open any browser, it will have title here, right? So this title is for the end user who is looking at the browser to differentiate the screens. For example, here if you see, it says Google. Here it says window handle practice, right? So to differentiate that one. So in the similar way, WebDriver also should have something which can differentiate from one window to another window, right? So for that, Selenium WebDriver will identify each and every window based on one unique string value. So that string value we call it as handle. So if you want to go to any window, we use this handle string value, then we can navigate to that window. After navigating to that window, we can perform the operations. Okay. So here I should not use the word navigating to, because the navigation is having a different meaning in our Selenium, right? It is like from one web page to another web page you navigate. So here we are not navigating from one web page to another web page. We are navigating from one browser window to another browser window. So we say switching, okay? From one window to we are going to another window. So we will say switching between two windows here. We will not say navigation, okay? Here it is a switching process. So now let me open the Eclipse and perform these operations, okay? So I'll create one class file here. I'll name this class file as window handle demo. Window handles demo. I need a main method also. So here I need the code for launching the browser, right? So I will copy that code from my earlier classes. So let me just copy paste here. And close this one. So here my URL is different now. So what is my URL first? Let me close this one also. So this is my URL, right? So I'll copy this. Paste it here. So this line will open the website for us. So now what we need to do? We need to perform click operation in this button. So let me inspect this button. So you see this button is having one class name and one ID. If it is having ID, name, class name, the most preference one is ID obviously, right? So I'll go with ID here. So driver.findElementById dot click. So this line will open the new window for us like this, right? Sorry, I clicked on the wrong one. So this one, this will open the new window, right? So now I wanted to enter text into this first name, but before that, as I said, every window will have some handle, right? So let me see what this handle is actually. Okay, so let me just close this. I'll go here. So to get the handle, we have two methods, okay? One is get window handle and the other one is get window handles. So let me show you here, driver dot get window. So here you see get window handle and the other one is get window handles. So the first one, what it will do, the current focused windows handle, it will return. As I said, a handle means a unique string value. So it will return that string value. If you say get window handles, what it will do, if you open two browser windows, for example, from one browser window, you clicked on one button and it opened other browser window. So it will return that both the browser windows handles. Okay. So now after clicking on this one, anyway, it will open another browser window, right? So I'll get two browser windows in that case. So I'll get two handles here. So let me just get those two handles. So this get window handles will return set of string. So from this also you can understand it is a set. What is the difference between set and list basically? So set will not allow duplicate values. Set will allow only unique values and list will allow duplicate values, right? So as I said, this get window handles will return the handles and every handle is a unique string value, right? So that is why it is returning all the unique string values. So to store all the unique string values, we are using set here, right? So I will say set of string window handles. So here what I will do, before handling this one, before clicking on this button, first I will store the current window handle. Get window handle. Okay. So before clicking on this button, my main page, main window, this is my main window, right? So this window handle I am going to store. So as I said, this is only a normal get window handle, means it is returning only one value. So it is a string value. So I will store like parent window handle. Okay, basically it is not a window handle, it is a handle, parent handle, and here normal handles. Okay, so I'll import this one. So I need to print all these things. I'll print this one here itself. I'll say parent window. So the parent window handle I'm printing here. Then here I'll print this one. So I'll use for each. I will say handle sysout. So here I'm not mentioning anything. I'll simply write handle. So to differentiate, anyway, we are using this parent window text here, right? Okay. So after this, I will close the browser. So before closing the browser, I will give some thread.sleep here so that you can see the extra window, right? I'll give 2 seconds. So let me execute this. You will see it opened the extra window also and it closed the pop-up browser completely. So it printed here. So if you see here, the parent one is printed, then the child windows are 2. Okay, so here if you see this one and this one, these both are unique values, right? So similar way, for example, if you have 10 buttons and you click on 10 buttons and 10 new windows are opened, even then you will have each and every browser windows handle as unique. Okay, so now if you observe here, this one CB530 and this one CB530 and ends with DEC DEC here. So these both are equal, right? So when you are getting this parent window, we are getting the single value, and when you are using this get window handles, this get window handles will include the parent window also, the parent window and the child windows. And you can observe one more thing here. The parent window string value will always come in the starting one. So it will be first 0 index one. Okay. Then the rest will come. All the child windows. Okay. So that is one more thing you should remember. Why? Because for suppose you forgot to store this parent handle. And after you perform some operations and you thought like you wanted to come back to original window, you did not store this into parent window handle. But how you will come back? You can get the first value in the set. So that will be always a parent window only. Okay. So now what we will do, we will perform the operations inside this one. So here if you see, I have first name here. I will enter some text into this first name. So let me inspect this first name. So that first name is having one ID. Okay. I will copy this ID. I'll close this. So here I will write, let me write first, then I will explain you, okay. Dot send keys hello, or I will say my name Yadav. Okay. So now from this one I am getting 2 window handles, and here I have already parent window handle. If I remove this parent window handle from this one, I will have only child window handle. So I can simply switch to the child window handle and I can execute this piece of code, right? So what I will do, I'll keep it as it is. If this handle is not equal to parent window handle equals parent window handle, I need to add the negative condition. So if this is not equal to parent window handle, then I need to perform this one, right? So before performing the operation on the field, I need to switch to that window, right? Here I am getting the handle, but I am not using this handle. So let me use the handle here. So basically for finding an element, we have a syntax driver.findElement by, we use the locator and locator value. Then we get the web element, right? So on top of that web element, we perform the operations. Here we need to switch to the child window. So here the syntax is driver.switchToWindow. Okay. So in our earlier video also we have seen, if you want to perform any operation on the alert, we switch to the alert, then we perform the operation on the alert, right? So the same way, if you want to perform operations on window, you need to switch to that window. So here it is saying name or handle. So I am passing handle. Okay. So you need to understand, I got 2 window handles from this one, the main window handle and the child window handle. So here I'm putting one condition. If it is not a parent window handle, then switch to that window, then perform this operation. Okay. So after performing this operation, I will give thread.sleep of 5 seconds. We can see the difference. Okay. Then I will close that window. Okay. So for closing any browser window, we have two methods, close and quit. So when you use close, it will close the only focused one. So here we are focusing into child one, right? Our focus is switched to child window. So I wanted to close the child window only. So I will use close method. The other method what we have is quit. So when you quit, it will kill all the browser windows which are opened by the driver. It will close all the browser windows. So I'll close this browser window instance. Then I'll come out. Okay. So after coming out, what I need to do? So here I have one text box. Okay. So I will enter some text into this one. Then only I will understand, right, whether my control is shifted back to this one or not. So here this is having one ID. So let me copy this. So after this for loop, okay, driver dot find element by ID, we need to enter some text. Okay, so here I will say ready. So I just missed this one. Now it is fine, right? So I'm not closing the browser. Okay, so let me execute this. So what is our expectation? Basically, it should open the URL main web page, then it will click on the button, the child window will open. In the child window, it will enter the Yadagiri text, then close the child window and come back and enter Reddy in this name. Okay. Oh, I think we got some issue. Okay. Let me check what it is. It says new window button is not available. I think it is not able to find out immediately. Okay, so I will give some thread.sleep or I will give some implicit wait. Okay, let me give some implicit wait. Timeout.implicit wait. I will give 60 seconds. Find unit. Stop. Seconds. Okay. So now we should be able to execute that. Okay. So let me run this again. So the browser window is opened and it opened the child window also. Here you see the first name it entered Yadagiri. Okay. Now it has to close the child window. It closed. And here it need to enter Reddy text here in the name. Okay. It is not entering. So let me just check here. So as expected, here we got some exception, right? Saying that no such window. So when you are dealing with this window handles, you get this exception often, very often. Why? Because you see here where my driver focus is actually. I switched to the child window and I closed the child window. After that, I'm not coming to the parent window. I'm still in that child window mode only. Okay. And then I'm trying to find out one element, but the child window is already dead. We closed the child window, right? So it is not able to identify. That is what it is saying. No such window. Target window is already closed. So here we need to first switch back to the parent window. That you should remember. Okay. So when you are dealing with window handles, you need to switch back to the original parent window always. Okay. Driver dot switch to window. I have parent window handle, right? So I will say semicolon. So now let me execute the same thing again. Okay. I close this. I close this browser also. So this time, it should execute perfectly. The ready text also should be entered in that name text box field, right? So the main window is opened. The child window is opened now. It entered text in the child window. Now it should close the child window. Now you see in the main window, in this text box, text ready is entered. Okay. So this is what I want to show you. So now let me close this. Okay. So now we handled one window, right? So now let me show you the same with one tab, how it looks like. So let me just copy this. So first we'll see what this is opening. So okay, no problem. So this is also opening the same browser window. Okay, that means same URL. So I don't need to change this entire code. I'll simply change this button name. Okay, so this will click on the second button. So one extra tab will open. So in that we are finding this first name and we are entering this one. Okay, so I'm not changing anything here, it is as it is, and let me execute. So basically any opened window or any newly opened tab, both are called window handles only. Now you see it opened one extra tab, it entered the Yadagiri text here, and the tab is closed and it entered Reddy text here. You see, so basically we did not close the browser, so that is why it is still active. I will close this browser. So here we go. Without any exception, we executed it, right? So this is how you need to handle the windows and tabs. So anything, tab or window, they both come under window handle only. Okay. So now you can practice the other things. Like I have given two windows. Okay. So just try like this. Enter something here, then close this window and go to this window, enter some text here, and without closing this one, go to this window, execute something here, then come back to this window. So this will already be filled by the time. Come back to this window, then enter last name. Okay. So that means you are switching from child window to parent window, again from parent to child. So practice like this, then only you will get to know what, how we need to handle these window handles. Okay. So the same applies to this one, multiple tabs. And the last one is multiple tabs and windows. It will open four things. Okay. Two tabs and two windows. So switch between all these things and try. It will be fun, guys. So try these things. And if you have any doubts or any queries regarding this one, please let me know in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.
I hope you enjoyed this session. If you like this video, please hit the like button and also share it with your friends. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.